Hello students, welcome back to the English class. I'm your English teacher Shabina Khan. Yesterday I taught you summary of this chapter, The Little Girl. So today I'm going to teach you this chapter. I'm going to explain this chapter to you. So let's start it. Before you read, do you feel you know your parents better now than when you were much younger? So do you think so? It happens with us students. Sometimes we misunderstand. Sometimes we misunderstand other people. We think that they are so bad. But gradually, after some time, we understand that that person was not as bad as we were thinking. So it is just, this was the situation with Kezia also. She thought that her father was very bad person, but after some time, after an incident, when he felt his love for her, then she found out that her father was a loving father, was not a bad person. Perhaps you now understand reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. Upset means to sad. This story is about a little girl whose name was Kezia, and whose feelings for her father changed from fear to understanding. In the earlier, she used to fear to her father, but after that, she understood that her father was not a bad person. He was a busy person actually. So what kind of father students do you have? Maybe some of you have a friendly father. Some of you maybe have an angry father, busy father, but all are your fathers, all are good. So let's start the chapter. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. So for Kezia, her father was actually a person to be feared, and she always tried to avoid him. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss. Just like another father's, he used to love his daughter Kezia, to which she responded with good boy father. She only said in reply just goodbye. She was not so fond of him. And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. So here carriage for car we have used. And fainter means less loud. When he went his office, then Kezia felt relief. In the evening, when he came home, she stood near the staircase, means near the stairs, and heard his loud voice in the hall. Bring my tea into drawing room, because he was actually a very dominating person. So that's why most of the time he used to shout in the house. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my paper's out there and bring me my slippers. So here Kezia's father was ordering his mother to bring his slippers. Kezia, mother would call to her, if you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boots. So here mother is saying to bring boots of her father. Slowly the girl would slip down. Slip down means come down quietly and unwillingly. More slowly, still across the hall, and push open the drawing room door. By the time he had his spectacles means powered glasses on and looked at her over them in a way that was terrifying to the little girl. So he looked at her like which was causing fear to Kezia. Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today? So father is asking to Kezia, have you been a good girl or not? Because he wanted her to be a good girl all the time. I don't know, father. And then she used to stammer in front of him because she was afraid. She was trying to speak properly, but unfortunately she always stammer in front of him. She was not able to speak properly. You don't know, if you stutter like that. Stutter means not speaking properly, not able to speak properly. Mother will have to take you to the doctor. Here father is saying the mother will have to take you to the doctor because she was not speaking properly. She never stuttered with other people. Now mother is saying she never stuttered other people, had quite given it up. Quite given it up means she has lived up, she has stopped doing it now. But only with father, because then she was trying so hard to say the words properly, because she was so conscious in front of her father. That's why she was stuttering, she was stammering. What is the matter? What are you looking so rest? What are you looking so rest about? Rest means unhappy. Here father is asking, is there any problem with you, Kezia? Why are you looking so unhappy? Mother, I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide. Here, he was getting worried about Kezia because according to him, she was about to commit suicide by behaving like that. So here Kezia carried my teacup back to the table carefully. He was so big, his hands and his neck, especially his mouth when he yawned. Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant. So according to her, her father was like a monster. Giant means a monster. On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother, because grandmother always wanted to, a good relation of Kezia with her father. So that's why she sent her to his drawing room to talk to him. But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa. So they both were busy. Father was also busy in sleeping and taking rest, and mother was also busy in reading newspaper, and she was all alone. His handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushions, sleeping, cushions means pillow, sleeping soundly. He was sleeping completely with the full rest and snoring. So you can see the picture also how he was sleeping. She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he woke and stressed and asked the time, then looked at her. So she started staring at him, that what kind of a father he was. Don't stare so, Kezia, you look like a little brown owl. So then her father got up and he said, Kezia, don't look at me, you are looking like a brown owl. One day when she was kept indoor with a cold, her grandmother told her that father's birthday was next week and suggested that she should make him a pincushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. So her grandmother suggested to Kezia to give a gift to her father, and she should make that herself. Laboriously means with lot of efforts, with lot of hard work. With a double cotton, the little girl stitched three sides. She did lot of hard work to give a best gift to her father, but what to fill it with? Now she was thinking that what to fill that pillow, that was the question. The grandmother was out in the garden and she wandered means she was moving here and there in search of something to fill her pillow. Into mother's bedroom to look for scraps. On the bed table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine paper, gathered them up, tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed her case, then sewed up the fourth side. So it was so terrific because she didn't know those papers were so important for her father. Now what is going to do? Let's see. That night there was a hue and cry. Hue and cry means angry protest, angry shouting. Her father was in anger because he was looking for his papers and he was not able to find his papers. So that's why he was shouting loudly. Father's great speech for the port authority had been lost. His father's great speech was lost. He had to represent that speech in front of port authority. Port authority means higher authorities in front of just because maybe his manager, maybe his owners, employers. in front of his employers. So room was searched. Everywhere he searched, servants questioned. Finally, mother came into Kezia's room. Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some papers on a table in our room. Now, mother asks to Kezia, have you seen any paper or not? Oh, yes, she said. She didn't lie. I tore them up for my surprise. How sweet. She was so innocent. She actually confessed what she did. And then what is going to happen? Let's see. What screamed mother? Come straight down to the dining room this instant. Then her mother was shouting because she was crying that what has she done. And she was dragged down to where father was, and she was moved up down where father was pacing to and fro, hands behind his back. He was waiting for her, and impatiently he was waiting for her. Well, he said sharply, mother explained. He stopped and stared at child. He looked at her. Did you do that? No, she whispered. She speaks slowly. Whispers means when you speak slowly, then we call it whispered. Mother go up to her room and fetch down the damn things, useless things. Here for her father, those things were useless because now she has actually destroyed his important papers. So that's why those things were useless for him, because he was in anger at that time. She said, see that child's put to bed this instant. Now her father was ordering to put her to the bed, otherwise he was going to punish her badly. So just he wanted to remove her at that time in front of him. Crying too much to explain, she lay in the shadows. Now she was crying very much. Shadowed means in the dark room, watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floors. And she was crying a lot. She was in the dark room, lights were off, and she was watching the patterns on the floor. Patterns mean designs. The father came into the room with a ruler in his hand, and then father came to punish her. I am going to beat you for this, he said. He was going to beat her. Oh no, she screamed and she cried, hiding under the bedclothes. Now she was trying to hide herself in the bedclothes. He pulled them aside. Sit up, he ordered, and hold out your hands. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you. Now he was punishing her. He was beating her with a stick, with a scale on her hands, but it was for your birthday. She said, father, I made gift for you on your birthday. Down came the ruler on her little pink palms, but he didn't listen to her and he punished her. He actually beat her with a stick on her palms, ruler, stick, and clung to hold tightly. So I have written word meanings also. I'll send you word meanings. Hour later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. What did God, clung means to hold. What did God make fathers for? Now she is actually complaining to God. She sobbed, she cried a lot. Here is a clean hanky, darling. Blow your nose, go to sleep, pet. You will forget all about it in the morning. I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. Here, her mother is saying that she tried to stop her father, but he didn't listen to her. But the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back. But she never forgot that, and she always remembered that. And she, according to her, her father was a monster. Her father was a giant. And a red color flew into her cheeks. The McDonald's lived next door, and they had five children looking through a gap in the fence. So there was another family, a McDonald family. There, Mr. McDonald was actually a very cheerful person, very nice person, who always used to play with his children. Looking through a gap in the fence means border, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening, the father with the baby, Mao on his shoulders, two little girls hanging on his coat pocket, tag, a children's game of catching one another. It is a tag. When we catch one another, that is called tag. Ran round and round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. Once she saw the boys turn the hose on him and he tried to catch them laughing all the time. Then it was she decided there were different sorts of father. Then she understood that all the fathers are not like that. All fathers are not like my father. Some fathers are good also. Suddenly one day mother became ill and she and grandmother went to hospital. The little girl was left alone in the house with Alice, the cook. That was all right in the daytime. Here Mr. McDonald is playing with his children. So she wanted her father like this. The little girl here, Kezia, is watching them and just thinking how happy they are. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. What will I do if I have a nightmare? Nightmare means bad dreams. If bad dreams will come, then what will she do? She asked, I often have nightmares and then granny takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark, it all gets whispery. So she was missing her grandmother because every night she used to sleep with her. So that's why she was thinking if she would have bad dreams, then what would she do? You just go to sleep, child, said Alice, pulling off her socks, and don't you scream and wake your poor pa. But same old nightmare came, and the butcher with a knife, butcher means that person who sells meat, with a knife and a rope, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile, while she could not move, could only stand still, crying out, Grandma, Grandma. She walks shivering to see father besides her bed, a candle in his hand. So when she was full of fear, when she was in need, her father came and he was actually with her. What is the matter? He said, oh, a butcher and knife, I want granny. She said, I want my dadima, I want my granny to help me, to console me because I had a nightmare. He blew out the candle, went down and caught up the child in his arms, carrying her along the passage. Passage means corridor, to big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed, a half-smoked cigar was near his reading lamp. He put away the paper, threw the cigar into the fireplace, then carefully tucked up. Tucked up means covered up nicely in bed. Tucked up the child. He lay down beside her, half asleep, still with the butcher smile all about her. It seemed at that time. She crept close to him. Snuggles means moved into a warm, comfortable position close to another person. So moving into comfortable position to someone. Her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. Then the dark did not matter. She lay still because she was with the protective person. She was in the protection of a father. So she didn't fear at that time. Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm, said father. And her father was consoling her and giving her a lot of love. Tired out, he slept before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father, not so big after all. And with no one to look after him, he was harder than grandmother. Now she was thinking that my father is working hard and he don't have anyone to take care of him. He's not bad person. He's not a bad person at all. But it was a nice hardness, and at that time she was feeling good with her father. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. McDonald's. Mr. McDonald's had a different profession, so that's why he got time to play with her, with his children. He got time to spend with his family, but her Kezia's father was a busy man, so that's why he didn't get time to spend with his family, with Kezia also. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. Now, many writings she has written, many things she has written against her father. Now she has torn all those writings. She stirred suddenly. She moved suddenly and sighed a deep breath. Sigh means a deep breath. She took a deep breath. What is matter? Asked her father. Another dream. Oh, said the little girl, my hat's on your hat. I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, father dear. And then she felt the love of her father. He was actually a nice father, a caring father, but he was busy. She was just misunderstanding her. So that's it, students. It was your chapter. Now you have to do all the question answers. I will send your answers. First of all, you have to try to do all the answers. So that's it for today. Have a nice day. I hope you liked my video. Thank you. Bye for now.